So now it's time to actually implement the changes we talked about in the last video. To start with, I'm going to open the Create screen in an image editing software. I'm going to use Paintbrush, a free image editing software for Macs, but feel free to use whatever software you like. So for me, I will go up here, go to Open, and browse my way to the correct screen. So now that I'm here, what we're seeing is that we have this event language here, and everywhere else in the class, we use this language of task. So the first task for us will be to change this event word to task. Now, it's fairly easy to do that in a program like this. I'm actually just going to copy this, Command C, Command V, and cover that up. It's not the cleanest, but it works. And as with all prototyping, what works is what you should be doing. So let's remove this event word from the screen. Now we need to add the task word to the screen. So this won't be ideal, but it will actually convey the information we're trying to convey. So now that I've done that, I can save, and then I can close out. If we wanted to upload this so that my prototype was now using it, we would press this plus button. See how it says drag and drop? We can simply go up to create, drag that, and drop that. And because it has the same name, we now have task over here. Anytime you're uploading a screen to your envisioned prototype, which has the exact same name as a previous screen, it will override that screen. So now when I go into this screen that we've just created, and I go to the build mode, you'll see that it already has these hotspots. And so it already knows that it's supposed to link /close when I press the create button. Now let's think another thing. If we want to have these checkboxes show up somewhere, and they need to be good, well, the first place we encountered checkboxes was this calendar day. So let's open up this calendar day in our image editing software. So as we can see, it currently has these checkboxes, which are these gray circles, and then they turn into blue circles with checks in them. That was confusing to some of our users, so again, we're going to just cover this up. There's no need to be fancy with it. And then we'll replace that. So I like Paintbrush because it comes with this nice tool for just putting out rounded boxes. So I can just make this square checkbox. I'm holding the shift key down to make sure that it's actually square. And then I can switch over to this copying tool again, grab that, and copy it on down. I'm going to try and line these up, but they won't be perfect, and that's all right. Again, you want the least time spent on your prototype as possible. So again, we've cleaned this up. It's much better. We have these checkboxes. Let's save and upload that screen. So again, click this plus button and move the calendar day on over. So by doing that, we've now got these checkboxes here, and we've now got all of the hotspots already there. So we can click on this and go to the week or the month, create an event, go back to this drawer. The final thing we wanted to do was make sure that the home screen had these checkboxes. And we can do that in one of two ways. Either we can take our current home screen and add the checkboxes, or we can take a look at this calendar day, see that it has all the same information as our current home screen, but also has checkboxes, and say, well, maybe we don't need actually this home screen anymore. So instead, I'm going to go through the hotspots that we already have and change them so that rather than pointing at home, they point at calendar day. To do that, I'm first going to go into this view part, then I'm going to click on build mode, and that'll bring up all the hotspots. So the way I've done this, home is the one that currently points at the home screen. We want home to point at calendar day, so we just change that, click save, and now if we go back to our preview mode, click on home, it'll bring us to calendar day. There are a few other places we'll need to do this change, so let's move on through. The first place is in your sign-up screen. usually when you click this create an account, it'll link you to home or to your walkthrough. You can change that to calendar day if you like. If you have it pointing at the walkthrough, then you have to change this to point at calendar day. And again, every time, it's very simple. Click on this, click on the dropdown, go to the right screen, and then click save. So here's our home. We don't actually have to change anything from this home to remove it from the prototype. All we need to do is change the things that would otherwise point to this home screen. So going through this, it looks like there aren't any other places where we know we need to change the hotspot. There are places where we might have to change the hotspot. Depending on how you implemented this new screen, this create might go to link back close, or it might currently be pointing at the home screen. Similarly for this back button up here. Check those before you move on. The last one is this sign in. Very often this will be pointing towards home, and you'll want this to be pointing towards calendar day. With all of that done, we can go to our preview mode and click around to be sure that we've done this right. So let's try signing in. And wonderful, now we're on this screen with the checkboxes. That's what we wanted. If we take a look at creating a task, we now see that it does say, in fact, task. It's a little bit spaced weird, but it took us 5 minutes to do. Wonderful. Now your test project should have reacted to all of the feedback we got in our first round of user testing, which means, of course, that it's time for more user testing.